Interesting thing about Denner, like the vineyard, we overbuilt for our production at this point. So in order to supplement, let me make sure Mike's turning his lights. Hey, Mike.
Where are we?
Denner, yes. In the
so we overbuilt the facility, thinking that eventually we'll at least partially grow into it. And in the meantime, we supplement by renting out space to other winemakers and wineries. So we currently have 7 winemakers making 11 different labels out of here. Amy Butler has Ranchero Cellars, and she was previously with Ed Cellars. Ed Cellars is building their facility and will be out this year. Hillary and Simon Graves make Graves Family Wine Growers, which is mostly off of their estate vineyard in Creston. Jacob Toft makes Jacob Toft Ranger Project, Westbound Wines, and Edmund August out of here. All of those are very small. Jacob Toft is the largest of them at about 700 cases. Jordan Fiorentini makes the Epic Estate Wines. Jordan was previously the winemaker at Chalk Hill up in Sonoma and started with Epic in June. And then Scott Hawley is coming back in. He's been here off and on with different projects. Jada was originally in here. He was here with Hearthstone for some time, and then a now defunct label called Vita Luce. So he'll be in with a new project that's got a vineyard off of Peachy Canyon Road this year. And then we have Paul Ayers, who has Hearthstone now, and then myself, and I have Denner, and then my own label, Canero, that I do out of here. So we split everything. Everybody sort of has their designated premise, and we alternate some equipment. This area is all Epics, and they have an entire in-house lab. They do all of their numbers in-house. They're very scientifically oriented. I am much more on the artistic side. As long as the numbers are microbially stable, I don't care what they are, as long as it tastes good, because you guys don't taste numbers, you taste wine. So in-house we run, I have that corner that I split with Jacob. We run PHTA, which is titratable or total acid, sugar content, and then free sulfur, and that's it. And those are the things we're just running to the lab most of the time, so we figured we might as well do it in-house. Everything else is on a case-by-case basis, and we're shipping out to Brenda Baker here in town. She does our lab analysis for us. Though typically we're putting together blends and then just, what's the alcohol?
Yeah.
So we can put it on a label.
Yeah, the label.
The whole design of this facility, of this lab in particular, is based around this table in that Passerolles is very much a blended wine region, and we wanted to have a spot where we could blend. And the beautiful thing of having 6 or 7 different winemakers in here is you've got 6 or 7 different people with different backgrounds. We have Fresno, Davis, Cal Poly, Army Corps of Engineers, philosophy majors, you know, and everybody's got different experiences of where they've worked and the varieties they've worked with, and we're all playing with very similar stuff. I mean, there isn't anybody totally out there with the varieties. Everybody's doing their own for the most part. A little bit is in, a little bit of Bordeaux, Tempranillo. So it's all similar stuff, and everybody's got their own perspective on it. So we can get in here and mock up all of our different lots and our blends and have everybody taste in sort of a collaborative fashion. And I think that's one of the strong suits of Passerolles, is that we are so collaborative, and that we're all working to, as you guys were speaking last night, promote Passerolles. And if, you know, Epic makes a great wine or Saxon makes a great wine, it's going to help all of us here to bring people in. So let's head out to the cellar where the fun is.